Hello everybody, welcome to the lesson on colour theory. What this is just showing you a line of colours that you can use to organise your palette so that you're able to mix darken the colours or mix shades by using just pairs of colour rather than using black. This is how it's organised. This would be organised if I was trying to mix greens or blues. I'd organise it this way. The blues in the middle, greens slightly in the middle, maybe purples. But I'll just show you how this has arrived at. It goes back to very early colour theory. A way of getting that line of colours, if you have to go back to the very early colour theories where the pure red and the pure yellow and pure blue were seen as the three primary colours. This is the best way of understanding colour theory, I think, if you start from those points. Because all you need to remember is just yellow, red and blue. Put a triangle in. And then there we call those the primary colours, the pure primary colours. And put the, if you mix yellow and red together, you get orange. Mix blue and red, we get purple. Blue and yellow, we get green. Put a square around those. Now, the secondary colours, so if you mix the secondary colour with the primary colour, we'll get the third colour. Then if you mix the third colour with the secondary colour, we'll get the fourth colour, we'll get the fifth mix, the sixth, go on forever, going on and on. But you have to find colours for each one. So to make it easier, what we do is we just focus on tertiary colours. We don't go any beyond that, we stay with tertiary. So any colour between the secondary and the primary colour we'll call tertiary colours. Best way of getting them is not try and get the middle one, find two either side of the middle centre one, so we don't have to give it a name. So if I just bring a line in, if I then mix orange with red, leaving more red in it, I get an orange red. And then if I mix the same with a mixed orange and red, leaving more orange in it, I get a red orange. The last word is the actual name of the colour, so because it's red, it's got more of a bias of orange in it. The other side of the red will be a purple red, and the red purple, blue purple, purple blue, green blue, blue green, yellow green, green yellow, orange yellow, and finally the yellow orange. Now you end up with 18 colours, which is a nice group of numbers. And as you can see, I've lined all these colours up at the top, following these ideas. And obviously, you'll get lots of different blues, but quite a lot of the blues will be green blues. We don't get many purple blues. In fact, the purple blues, perhaps the light cobalt blue. Definitely the French ultramarine blue is going on. It's got a powerful purple bias to it, but only slight. Yeah, most of the blues will be green, but if you can see oranges slightly towards red, you can see this all with your naked eye. But this is so essential to be able to do this. So if you can then identify each colour you've got as belonging to one of these, and then put them in a line, that's essential learning for two colour mixing. So if you can try this, everybody at home, try and do this, try and organise your colours. Where can you place all the yellows? Where's the yellow? If you look at the yellows, you'll see one slightly orange, so then you've got the cadmium yellow over here, lemon yellow there, the yellow greens, you've got bright green, or the yellow green, any other yellow greens, you've got permanent green, belongs to the yellow green. The permanent green, if you look at it, it's perhaps the closest to the pure green than the others. But then you go over towards the blue green, you get viridian green, emerald green as well belongs to that area. And then as you move over, you get the green blue. This is the cerulean blues. Quite a lot of green blues. Prussian blue, Tarlo blue, cyan blue, all that. The cerulean blue I've put there is perhaps the lightest one. It's easy to see in the camera, I think. So you get the cerulean blue here. Cobalt blue, it depends, you can get a cobalt blue, it's darker, it tends to be a green blue, so cobalt blue coming across down here in this side area. But also it becomes a purple blue, and it's a bit like this one looks to me, looks a bit purplish. But again, cobalt blue, a bit like the permanent green, is perhaps the purest colour, closest to blue. It's up to you what you think it's either side. If it's then you get the French ultramarine blue, which is definitely got a purple bias to it. Going over to ultramarine violet, it's going towards blue purple, missing the blue. The red purple is cobalt violet. Then we move over to the purple red. Purple red is magenta, which is now seen as the primary colour of the pigments. It's over this area, the purple red area. Rose madder is there. I suppose alizarin crimson is there as well, but I think alizarin crimson is a bit of a shade, and it's not quite as cool as the rose madder. I think rose madder is perhaps the most purest red we've got on the purple side. And over the other side, we get the cadmium red, which is closest to the pure red, and then vermilion. So you get cadmium red, vermilion over this side. Red orange goes on, jumping across. Remember, this is a circle or a triangle spinning round, and right across the other side over here, we have the cadmium orange. Red orange, cadmium orange coming across there. Chrome orange, cadmium yellow deep. I would say chrome orange is in between those two, would be here. The yellow looks like an orange, more orange. I'd put the cadmium yellow deep as something in between, kind of yellow orange. And orange yellow being cadmium yellow, and lemon yellow here, and back to where we started. And then it's just a case of cutting this whatever you want and putting out. If I'm looking at mixing this blue, I can maybe cut the opposite of the blue around, putting a line, and I can see I'm ready to start mixing blues. Obviously, I want to mix it a different colour, put the yellows in the middle. But it's really essential learning, everybody. If you really want to learn to how to mix colours with pairs, which is a really beautiful way of mixing, I think Edward Hopper, Vincent van Gogh, Monet, all those great modern painters were using pairs of colour to mix. So if you want to learn that, you've got to try and learn that. It's not as difficult as you think. Once you start doing it, it's a process you're learning. So good luck with that. See you soon.